Hello friends, how are you all? I hope you all are doing great. So in this class, we are going to study about our next scheme. That is your 8th one scheme and a famous one also, Make in India, and the recent one. Okay, Make in India. Okay. So the initiative basically promises the investor both domestic and overseas a conducive environment to turn 125 crore population strong India, a manufacturing hub, and something that will also create job opportunities. So if I tell you about the vision statement, which is written on their official site, that is www.makeinindia.gov.in. So it commits to achieve for the country, among other things, an increase in manufacturing sector growth to 12 to 14% per annum over the medium term, increase in share of manufacturing in country's gross domestic product from 16 to 25% by 2022, and importantly, to create 100 million additional job by 2022 in the manufacturing sector alone. Okay, so these are quite high ambitious target given the background that the manufacturing sector in India, which accounts for 4/5 of the total output, grew at a rate of 3.3% in January 2010. So this is quite a lot which they have written in the scheme. So let's see whether they are going to achieve it or not. So now let me tell you about the targets. Okay, so first one is to increase in the manufacturing sector growth from 12 to 14% per annum over the medium period. That is the first target. Second target is to increase the share of manufacturing in country's GDP from 16 to 25% in by 2022. Third one is to create 100 million additional jobs by 2022 in manufacturing sector. Fourth is to create an appropriate skill set among the rural migrants and the urban poor for the inclusive growth. Fifth is an increase in domestic value addition and technical depth in manufacturing. Sixth, enhancing the global competitiveness of the Indian manufacturing sector. Seventh is, and the last one, ensuring sustainability of growth, particularly with regard to the environment. So the country is expected to rank amongst the world's top 3 growth economies and amongst the top 3 manufacturing destination by as early as 2020, and we are in 2020 and we know it has not been achieved yet due to this pandemic. Also, the situation has just got worse only. Okay. So if I talk about the advantages that India have, so first one is that the sustained availability of quality workforce is the first advantage. Second is that the cost of manpower is relatively low as compared to other countries. And third is there are responsible business houses operating with credibility and professionalism. Also, the country has democratized polity and a strong consumerism intake ability of the domestic market. So these were the favorable outcomes for India to achieve the perspective that they have written in the Make in India prospect book. Okay, and if I add on some more favorable milestones, so it can be that there is a strong consumerism in the domestic market and also strong technical and engineering capabilities backed by top-notch scientific and technical institute. Okay, and you know that there are now well-regulated and stable financial markets also, which is open to the foreign investor. As you can see recently, in the Jio has made a lot of deal with foreign investor. They have raised their stock or their company valuation very high. Okay, and due to that also, the Mukesh Ambani came ninth in the Forbes list. Okay, so this is just the current scenario. So let's come back to topic. So a technological acquisition and development fund has been proposed for the acquisition of appropriate technologies, the creation of patent pool, and the development of domestic manufacturing of equipment used for controlling pollution and reducing energy consumption. Okay. And this fund will also function as autonomous patent tool and licensing agency. It will purchase intellectual property rights from the patent holder. So now we will discuss about the training of the workforce. Okay, so the manufacturing sector cannot develop on its own without a skilled labor force. So skill is very important. And in this context, it is heartening to note the government's initiative for the skill development. The creation of appropriate skill would definitely set rural migrants and the urban poor on track towards a inclusive growth. That would be a vital step for boosting manufacturing. The Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has initiated the process of revising the national policy on skill development, and it is significant to note that under the Rural Development Ministry, government has undertaken another few new initiatives for skill development program named as Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gramin Kaushalya Yojana, that is DDU-GKY, which we have already done, and its motive was to skill development for inclusive growth. So the new training program envisages the setting up of at least 1500 to 2000 training sectors across the country, and the entire project would result in an estimated expenditure of 2000 crore. Okay, and this new training program would enable the youths to get jobs in demand-oriented markets such as Spain, US, Japan, France, China, etc. Okay, so the government proposes to train about 3 lakh youths annually, 3 lakh youths annually for the first 2 years, and by the end of 2017, it has set a target of reaching out as many. It had set a target of reaching out to as many as 10 lakh rural youth, but I guess this has not been achieved. Okay, so the homework for you today is that see the current growth, and actually homework for every video is to whatever I teach, it is just the timeline of before what you have done, but we don't know the current status. So what you need to do, you need to search Make in India and see the current status and whatever I have said, that whether they have achieved it or not, because we are now in 2020. So we have all information about whether the target that was set by all the programs is achieved or not. So this is your homework. So stay tuned, guys. Thank you for watching. We will meet in next videos. Bye.